Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of LEGO Weaponry. And, well, there's one thing I would like to say to you guys. Well, the first thing is, I'm sorry for keeping you guys waiting for another episode, so I'm sorry for that. And I got good news for you and myself to tell you guys, if that makes any sense. Anyway, the good news is, well, I've been to the doctors for a checkup on my toes and everything else. And funny enough, they're nearly there, so yes, I'm pleased to hear that, and yes, hopefully they get better soon, you know, that way I can go back making good old weapons for you good old people out there, whoever's supported my channel and subscribed and all that stuff, you know, you're doing a fantastic job for what you're doing, but either way, I'm letting you guys decide if you want to support the channel or not, so yes, it's a free deciding community, you know, it's all that sort of stuff, but either way, I'm pleased to know that they're nearly there, the toe situation and everything else, they're nearly to the point where they're healing, so yes, I'm pleased to hear that. Either way, talking about this good old episode, in some ways I've took my time with this good old model for you guys, and well, funny enough, this is an existing realistic weapon in real life, although it has been used in Advanced Warfare and Call of Duty Ghosts. So, yes, funny enough, this is called, well, in real life that is, this is called the Beretta ARX-160. And yes, you may be thinking, that's what its name is in Advanced Warfare. Well, funny enough, that is what its actual name is in real life, funny enough. And I didn't know that, which is a new thing. Well, until now. But either way, let's show you this good old assault rifle. So, here it is. Oh yes, like I've said already, this is the Beretta ARX-160. So, yes, I don't know what the 160 is short for, but it's probably the model number or something like that, because they have been through loads of models in their times and everything else. So, yeah, they've been making like Mark 1s, Mark 2s, and all that stuff. So, yeah, that's just my, well, theory and opinion. So, yes, but either way, let's have a look at the good old facts about this Beretta assault rifle and the comparisons between the actual version, well, the Advanced Warfare version, because this is from this game and everything else. Well, I've made that version because I've kind of known war details and everything else because, well, I play the game myself sometimes, but I don't actually own the game. Well, it's one of my friends' games and everything else, so yes, either way, let's have a look at the facts and the comparison, shall we? Interesting. Right, let's show you the areas and the features of this particular assault rifle. First things first, well, pistol grip right here, trigger guard, now, the magazine. Now, I don't know much about the magazine, and I don't know what cartridge it holds. I think it holds like 7.56mm, I'm not so sure. I'm not that much of an assault rifle type of person, so I wouldn't know much about the cartridges it fires, but either way, the only information that helps me around assault rifles like this, for example, is a website called Wikipedia. Now, I don't know if you're familiar with that, but it's a website that I use to get facts coming along and everything else, and I have to, like, put the facts down in my own words as possible, you know, I take ideas from them and put them in. Anyway, that's just how I do things. Either way, here's the magazine. I think it holds a 30 round capacity, I'm not so sure, but either way, that goes in nicely. And what else? Oh, yes, the rear sight. Oh, this is the rear sight and that's the foresight. It's been a while since I've done another video, so yes, I would be a little bit messy, but either way. Now, these sights remind me from another assault rifle, that is, and funny enough, I've already made that assault rifle, and that is the AAC Honey Badger. So, yes, feel free to check that out whenever, but it's up to you, I'm not here to force me tell you, you know, decide for yourselves. And, well, funny enough, these sights look as though they are from that assault rifle, so, yes, I think they're the same type of sights, obviously, due to its design and everything else. So yeah, I kind of like the sights, you know. This is pretty darn flashy, if you may ask me. So yes, see your way. Attachment rail. Well, actually, he's got two, funny enough, because I did some speculation around the Advanced Warfare version that is, and I've realised it's only got two. There's only one. Well, actually, it's got three, just to correct myself, because there's one small one hidden here. There's one only on the left side, and there's one main one on the top for, like, optics and all that stuff, so... Yes. Barrel, muzzle, right here. Oh yes, the stock. Now, I don't know if this was extendable or something like that, but either way, I just made it just because of its design and everything else, so... Yes, hopefully you understand, so... Yes. Oh yes, this is the headrest, so that you could aim down your sights, but to be honest, they don't line up, to be honest. I must admit. But either way, I do have my head a little bit back, that way I can get myself aligned with the sights easily, so... Yes, either way. Here's the breech right here. Like so. And last but not least, the charging handle. Like so. And, well, I may have missed, like, select fires and everything else, but I couldn't really tell where they were. So, yes, unfortunately, I left them out and just carried on with the model as it was. So, yes, either way, hopefully this was worth your time and worth waiting for in the end. Oh, yes, and one more thing. These sights do fold so that you can put your optics and everything else, but unfortunately I haven't made any optics, so yeah, besides I was running out on pieces, so I had to get rid of my holographic sight that I used to have and everything else, so yes, either way, they do fold like so, pretty nifty, like so. Yes. But either way, this is all I have time for you guys out there today, unfortunately. But join me tomorrow, that is, as I'll probably be making a pistol from Black Ops 1. And funny enough, I have been through a couple of attempts at making this good old pistol, and they never turn out so great as I expected. And finally, I've come to the point where I've actually made it once again, and finally, it looks great. I must admit, it looks okay for what it was. So... Yes, either way, I'll be showing you that good old pistol, and, well, the only thing I could tell you is that it only fires a 9x19 Parabellum, obviously, because it's a pistol cartridge, and, well, there's some negative thoughts about it due to its capacity, and there's some good positive thoughts about it because of its quick reloading and its quick aiming and everything else, so... Yes, now, I think this is a default pistol you can get in Black Ops 1 multiplayer, so, yes, you're bound to know already what pistol I'm on about, but either way, hopefully you don't spoil it for me, and yourselves, obviously, because, well, I'm trying to keep you guys thinking and everything else, you know, I like to do that sort of thing and all itself until tomorrow, that is, so, yes, join me tomorrow for that good old pistol, but either way, hopefully this episode is worth your time, but if you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like or a comment down below on what you think of this episode, which would help me a lot, but if you really liked it, want to subscribe to my channel and keep the channel going, which would help me a lot as well, oh yes, keep up to date with videos that I do as well, oh yes, feel free, and we are doing a fantastic job for what you're doing, you know, the subscriber count is going higher as we speak, as you may think about it, you know, it's like every time I look at my channel, the subscriber count goes up by one or two people, so, or subscribers obviously, and that is amazing, you know, you guys out there for what you're doing for the channel so far is awesome, you know, you guys mean a lot, and the channel means a lot to me as well, so... Yes, as well as you guys, you know, the guys out there who support this channel and everything else. But either way, if you're new around the channel, you know, welcome. You know, it's appreciated for you to come along and have a look around, you know. Feel free to have a look at the LEGO weapons that I've done in the past or today. So, yes, have a look around, you know, welcome. I appreciate your efforts for what you're doing. So, yes, thank you very much. And, yes, like I've said already, join me tomorrow, that is, as I'll be making a pistol. Enough me yapping on, because it's going to get too long, obviously. And as always, enjoy the rest of your days. Salute!